Dozens of Filipino teachers have been recruited to work in Hawaii, which is facing a shortage of educators. Lilaine Ignao tells us more.
With the new school year just around the corner, the Department of Education in Hawaii was bracing to start the year with about 300 teacher vacancies. To address the shortage, 80 teachers from the Philippines were brought in to teach all across the islands.
I'm here for a better opportunity and to participate in an exchange teacher program to help with students with special needs.
This is the DOE's first international recruitment initiative, and before getting the green light to teach in Hawaii, these teachers had to be eligible for a special J-1 visa and have their credentials screened by an international evaluations company.
During that time, I juggled between the process also as well as my full-time work. And it's been a very long journey. So I started doing the orientation way back October. The process started maybe December by getting the passport as well as the renewal of my other papers.
Foreign recruitment has risen nationally to help cope with the chronic teacher shortage. The hired teachers have the ability to work in the U.S. for up to 5 years under the J-1 teacher exchange visa, but are required to return to the Philippines and teach a minimum of 2 years in the public school system.
The curriculum way back in the Philippines as well as in here is a bit different, I think, so we cannot grasp it a bit for now, but our colleagues as well as the other staffs of the school were able to help us.
Now, the local community is doing its best to welcome these teachers with open arms, from hosting welcome parties to some offering housing options to organizations holding drives to collect essential items to make the transition easy for them.
I was overwhelmed by the welcoming of the Filipino communities here, and of course, with all the donations from the FAUW and the Manaloa Nimitz Lions Club. So they all get to collect some stuffs for us, the teachers from the Filipinos, that the things we needed for our basic needs here in Hawaii.
Filipino students make up 30% of the student body in Hawaii, while teachers comprise of about 10%. The 80 teachers will start teaching this coming school year, with 50 of them teaching in Maui, where the teacher shortage is more dire. The DOE hopes to bring in an additional 200 teachers from the Philippines for the 2024-2025 school year. Lilaine Ignao, ABS-CBN News, Honolulu, Hawaii.
World News Now, Ukraine and President Volodymyr Zelensky warns that the war is coming to Russia. That's after three Ukrainian drones were downed over Moscow, slightly damaging two buildings in the business district. This is the latest in a string of alleged attacks from Kyiv after Russia earlier said it had also thwarted two drones, one of which was brought down close to the headquarters of the defense ministry. Zelensky says the war is returning to the territory of Russia, which he calls an inevitable, natural, and fair process. Zelensky has rejected the idea of a ceasefire that would leave Russia in control of nearly a fifth of the country. Over in the U.S., former President Donald Trump took aim at President Joe Biden and his Republican rival, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, during a rally in Pennsylvania. DeSantis was seen as a major threat to Trump at the beginning of the year, but his campaign has been flagging in recent weeks. Meanwhile, Trump has been indicted twice this year, but his poll numbers in the Republican presidential nomination race keep going up.
DeSantis is gone. The Sanctus is gone. He's just about over. I think if he ever made a comeback, it would be the greatest comeback in political history. He's gone. I think he's lost every high roller. And they say, what's his problem? I say, he's got no personality. I could have told you that a long time ago. A politician needs a little personality.
Tough end for the historic campaign of the Filipinas in the FIFA Women's World Cup 2023. The Filipinas were outclassed by Norway in their final game in Group A. Norway romped past the Philippines 6-0 in front of a crowd of over 34,000 fans at the Eden Park in Auckland, New Zealand. Norway progresses to the round of 16 as the second seed in Group A. The Filipinas made history at the tournament by scoring their first goal and win in the World Cup. They will next compete at the Asian Games next month, where they are grouped with South Korea, Hong Kong, and Myanmar in Group E. The Filipinas' historic campaign in the World Cup has inspired another all-female Filipino team to dream big on the football field. Michael Deliso reports.
From a Philippine dam site to a German soccer field, from trash to bronze medals, this group of former garbage collectors in Payatas, Quezon City has brought pride to the Philippines at a global football competition. The team bagged bronze at the World Fair Play Soccer Championship in Prora, Germany last July 22nd after defeating Mongolia on penalties. The group stage saw the Payatas-based girls end with 10 wins, 2 draws and 2 losses to earn the second seed behind Mongolia.
There's so much potential here in the Philippines for women's football, for women's development, for the game. The Philippines has one of the best gender equality scores in the world. And there's so much potential to harness that.
Moore, who hails from England, is also the co-founder of Fair Play for All Foundation, a non-profit organization that helps children and families in Payatas. He believes in the potential of football in the Philippines, adding it can be developed by creating more spaces and facilities to play in.
But when you look at the youth talents, the youth that's actually being produced here in the Philippines, there's so much that so much potential to train, to develop. But of course, there's for most kids, there's nowhere to play. So we can't develop the talents if there's nowhere to play.
The Philippine women's football team earlier clinched a historic first in its FIFA World Cup match against New Zealand. The victory has inspired the Payatas squad to aim for more and create a life beyond garbage.
Mas mahirap yung mga masura kaysa maglaro kasi gusto ko po i-level up pa yung skills ko para po makapaglaro pa sa mas competitive na liga rito sa Pilipinas.
Nung bata po, wala, nag-enjoy lang ako. Ganun. Tapos nag-enjoy kasi may mga certificate na natatanggap, may jersey, ganun. Kasi po, syempre, galing din po kami sa mahirap na lugar. So parang na-excite po kami pag may mga ganun bagay. May certificate, may bagong damit, may medyas. Gusto ko rin po parang syempre, varsity hanggang parang maging national team. Parang.
For others, the World Cup win proves girl power in football.
Yung football po kasi akala ko parang panlalaki lang. Pwede rin pala siyang pambabae. So parang para po sa akin, nakaka-proud po kasi babae po kami. Parang kaya po namin yung level na yun. Especially pag may nakakalaban pong lalaki. Sabi ng coach na parang hindi, kaya mo yan. Babae lang yan, kaya mo patumbahin yan na.
About 200 kids play football in Payatas every week at a sports center created by Fair Play. The foundation also supports 63 scholars, some of whom have already won several accolades in the local football scene and were tapped as varsity scholars in big Philippine universities. Michael Deliso, ABS-CBN News.
For most college students, it will take at least 4 years to earn a diploma. But for Helwina Sadora, it took 18 years before she could get hers. She transferred to the University of the Philippines Diliman in 2001, but her education had to take a step back as she took on jobs to support her siblings. This past Sunday, Helwina finally fulfilled her dream. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com.